In this episode, statistics, mood for a data set, coming up, back into action. Hey guys, and today we will be doing a little bit statistics, and I would like to give you a quick glimpse into kind of statistical things. Usually it's called central tendency, and it usually comes to 3M. I call them 3M. It's mode, median, and mean, and also range goes along with this 3M. But that's completely another story, and that's coming up. Now, we will be focusing on mode. What is the mode? So let's say you are given a data. So a data set, it's kind of a list of any information, any pieces of information that you are given. It could be numbers, letters, or anything else. Well, the observation, the data value that occurs the most number of times, that appears the most number of times in your data set, is called a mode. Or in other words, that this data value, this observation that shows up the most frequently. So this is your mode. This is kind of mnemonic device or mnemonic trick that might help you to remember this mode from median and distinguish it from median and mean, because when you work out with all of them, sometimes it might be a little bit confusing. So you could memorize it like this MO that show up in the word mode, and most, again, MO. So kind of this M and O that kind of pop out at you, so kind of looks a little bit dumb, but anyway, if it helps, that's fine. So mode means most frequently. Let's say you are given this data. So you're given a list of numbers, let's say 2, 5, 7, 1, 9, 2, and 4. And you are asked to come up with the mode. So just by observation, you have two tools that appear, that show up in your data set. All other numbers, they're completely different. So your mode is gonna be just 2. So you write it down. Usually mode is abbreviated to just two first letters. So MO usually stands for the mode. So the mode is just 2. Nothing fancy, nothing crazy. Yeah, it's just the way it is. Moving on, how about this one? So you have a list of letters from the word mathematics, and just check to see what letter appears the most frequently, and just ask yourself what letter occurs the most number of times in this word. So you have 2 M's, you have also 2 A's, and you have 2 T's, T and T. All right. If you look at other letters carefully, all of them are different, distinct. So it seems like you have 3 modes. Can you have 3 modes? Yes, you can. Well, to be perfectly frank with you, sometimes you have more than 1 mode. So the first example shows you that mode is 1. So in this case, yes, you have more than 1 mode. And you could just write it down. So your mode in this case equals M, A, and T. So you have three answers for the mode. That's totally fine. And I gave you this example on purpose to show you that sometimes it could be more than one. Just keep it in mind. Moving on, the last one. So my brand surname, Jan. If you look at these letters, all of them are completely different from each other. So you have Y, O, U, N, and G. So all of letters are different. So what does it mean? If you ask yourself what letter occurs, appears, shows up the most frequently. So they are all equal. All these letters appear equally. So there is no mode, and this is the answer. So no mode in this case. And as well, I gave you this example on purpose to just illustrate, to show you that sometimes, especially when all your data observations are completely different, totally different numbers, pieces of information, letters, or whatever comes along, if they are different, so in that case, the answer is no mode. So your data set has no mode. Well, I hope it helps you. Thanks for watching and train your brain. I know everyone hates maths, but if you like my video, please hit like, share with your friends, leave the comment down below, and be sure to subscribe so you will not miss out my new videos.